Good evening, everybody. I'm Sobhya Naksh, and it is my privilege as the curator of Jameel Naksh Museum to welcome and address you all who are here to witness and participate in this momentous and historic event, which is the relaunch of Jameel Naksh Museum at its new premises almost after two decades. Dr. Feridun Setna joined me here on behalf of the Friends of Jameel Naksh Museum to thank our guest of honor, Senator Ehtezaz Ehsan, for taking out time for us from his busy schedule. Well, senior art critic Marjorie Hussain was not here, and we are expecting her any minute. It all started as a dream. Jameel Naksh Museum was first inaugurated in February 1999 to honor and commemorate the living legend. It was the first private museum that was established for this country. It was a proof of the love and respect of his admirers and friends. It started off as a small space on Shar-e-Faisal, and now has expanded to this beautiful and purposely built space designed by Sazan Naksh. Now I would like to welcome our guest of honor, Senator Ehtezaz Ehsan, who needs no introduction, to please say a few words. Are you?
Dr. Setna, Dr. Yazdani, Ms. Naksh, ladies and gentlemen, I must confess, not an art critic, not an expert in the appreciation of art. So I am one like most of you. So my talk may not actually educate you too much about the paintings and exhibits here or the general atmosphere of art in Pakistan. But I'm here to celebrate the work of an amazing Pakistani who gives out an image of Pakistan that's based on plurality of thought, of visions, of images. And the images that you see around you today, as has been much written, two images stand out in Jameel Naksh paintings and works. The one is of the pigeon and the other is of the woman. And this reflects, in fact, a deeper, more sublime aspect of our society. And there is a third image which I have found very engaging, which I will mention, which I haven't found written about in many critics of art and of his works. But the two images that stand out, first of all, the pigeon is a bird of peace, a bird which of togetherness, be it Piccadilly Square or Badshahi Mosque in Lahore, there are pigeons in droves and they hold together and they bond together and they cause no harm to anyone, no violence to anyone. Bird or beast or any living species, living and moving species on this earth. The second image is that of the woman. And that, in fact, I think is more deep-rooted than just the canvases. It's deep-rooted in the artist himself. And that is the fact that we were originally, thousands of years ago, both in the Indus region and in the Gangetic region, we were matriarchal societies, which were dominated by women. And women actually don't go to war. So that was also an image and a message, I take one, of peace. And it is innate in our culture, in our poetry, in the centuries and millennia that we have spent and our ancestors have spent on earth, where the urge to turn to the mother, for instance, a man sick at 85 years old will invoke the mother, Nimae, as Shao San does in Mayani, Main kinnu aakha dard vichhode da haal ni. He turns to the mother. As Afzal Hasan Randhawa of Faisalabad, the late Afzal Hasan Randhawa said in a few verses, invoking the mother really, and turning to her, whether she was dead or alive, but turning to the mother. Shao San's mother was certainly not alive when he wrote, Mai ni mai kinnu aakha dard vichhode da haal ni. Because the mother is not there, and he says, who do I turn to now that you are not there? Afzal Hasan Randhawa puts it also very emotively when he says, Main daryama da haani sa, tarne pae gaye khaal ni maaye, inne phat mere jusse vich, itne zakhm mere jism pe hain, inne phat mere jusse vich, jinne tere vaal ni maaye, hun na dudh pyaami pura, vadde hon na baal ni maaye, te Afzal Hasan loha si par, kha gaya dard jangal nimaye. So there is an invocation to the mother, to the woman too. This is the, not just the Indus language, Indus culture, alone, although you find women like Soni Maiwal crossing the river. Maiwal is just playing the flute on the other bank of the Chenab, or Sasi crossing the Thals and the deserts, hot deserts, on bare feet, or Marvi, the heroine of Shajir Rasalo, or in the Gangetic side, there are women like Draupadi, women like Jhansi Ki Rani, dominant women. And the image of the woman is in fact an image that comes innately from within us. One may agree or disagree with many of the exhibits, but the third thing that I see in these exhibits, and that are to my mind very noticeable, are the eyes. If you look at all these pictures in front of me, for instance, it's the eyes that engage you. They're not technically just in the middle of the frame, wherever they may be, they hold you, they engage you, and they speak to you. And that is the speech that is always a speech that is non-violent. anti-violence. And that is something that is a message that we have to give today. And these eyes that Jameel Naqsh paints not only look at the world from inside to outside, but if you ponder upon them, they are in fact looking from the outside to the inside at what is going on in this woman's mind, in this woman's thoughts. That is also reflected in these paintings, and these women are speaking with their eyes. Jameel Naqsh's women and objects or subjects speak with their eyes. But the important thing, besides these three features that I notice, and being no critic, no expert at art, these strike out and stand out to me. The important thing for our social faculties and societies, and particularly in this day and age, and those that distinguish the animal from the man, and the civilized man from the uncivilized man, are in my estimation three. And these are essential to be made, to be dispersed around the world, and to be adopted as one thing that distinguishes man from animal is intellect. And intellect is reflected in the objects of art that are displayed in this museum. The other thing is altruism. Altruism really means good intentions, best intentions. And men, human beings, more civilized human beings, have better intentions than the uncivilized, less civilized ones. And altruism also means compassion. You try to be compassionate. Now, no doubt, compassion can be seen to some extent in animals also, but if an animal is hungry and the prey is available, there is no compassion. There's going to be no compassion. But human beings have developed the capacity and the faculties to be compassionate under extreme circumstances and under extreme difficulties and hurt and pain to themselves. They'll suffer pain to avoid giving pain to another human being. And this is a particular faculty that we need to develop in our world today. And the third thing that, into my mind, differentiates a human being from an animal, and a more civilized human being from a less civilized animal, a less civilized human being, is aesthetic sense. The sense to appreciate beauty. Beauty in art, beauty in poetry, beauty in scenes of nature, beauty in figures, beauty in situations that may appear to be dire, but a starving person offering the food available to him, to another one who is starving too, is a work and a moment of beauty. Now, this is what we need to adopt today as our values. We must use our intellect to adopt altruistic motives and to appreciate the beauty in others, rather than looking at the negative side and the things that are wrong with others. Nobody is perfect. So the important thing for the world which art teaches us is that there must be plurality and diversity. And to attain plurality and diversity, we have to be tolerant. Tolerance is above all the virtue that we must adopt. I know how about intolerance. The world itself is in great conflict. We have conflict in our own lands, in our society, in our own country. We have intolerance and we have patriarchalism. The matriarchalism of innate in us has been drowned and submerged by feudal patriarchalism over the last few centuries. It's been a long time, but it has been subdued. We need to actually practice tolerance, diversity, and plurality. And then, when we do that, we will enjoy and appreciate and the aesthetics of the works that have been displayed today in this new museum, which is a great gift to Karachi by the founders of the museum. I wish them the best of the luck. One founder, because of which I am particularly here, is the Welfare Society for Patient Care. And I already mentioned Dr. Yazdani, who's been, Nifat Yazdani, who's been a moving spirit behind works and displays of art and culture. But I want to thank you all for being here, for making this such a memorable occasion. I want to thank the organizers for having given me this particular honor of being the chief guest at the inauguration of this lovely museum. I'm sure this space will be kept varying, and you will see new exhibits and always new exhibits of Jameel Naqsh. I wonder whether they will display works by other artists, but I would encourage them very much to devote some space to the new young artists also, even if those be those that follow the tradition of Jameel Naqsh. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Etaza Sahab, for your advice. We will definitely follow this. Now I would like to call upon the eminent trustee of Jameel Naqsh Foundation and a very old and dear friend of Jameel Naqsh, Dr. Feridun Sedna, to say a few words.
Senator Etaz Ehsan and honored guests, on behalf of the trustees of the Jameel Naqsh Foundation Museum, I welcome you all today on the occasion of the relocation of the Jameel Naqsh Museum. It is fitting that on this, the occasion of the 70th year of independence, this museum has found a permanent place. The idea of the Jameel Naqsh Foundation Museum was born when a few friends discussed the idea of setting up museums and other centers to establish the status of art in our country. And what better beginning for this project than by preserving and cataloging the work of their friend Jameel. 3 years later, this became a reality. So the museum was set up in 1999, and though it has been functioning for the past 18 years, it has not benefited from a permanent and easily accessible location. The new location will add to the landscape of the city, and it is to be Jameel Naqsh's gift to the city, which became his home after partition. It will house a permanent collection of several hundred paintings donated by the artist himself. It will also house the collection of works of the artist owned by Najmi Surah. The majority of the works displayed here have not been exhibited before. This permanent display will allow access to all, students, lovers of art, and others, to see, to learn, to appreciate the work of an eminent artist that our country is proud of. On behalf of the chairman of the trust, Usmani Sahib, and the trustees, I would like to thank our chief guest for being here today. And many thanks to Shami Ahmed for dedication in the care of the museum for the past several years. The curator, Sobia Ahmed, for the painstaking work in setting up the exhibits. Sezan Naqsh for the design and construction of the museum. Najmi Surah for her contribution of several paintings for the museum. Thank you all for being here today. And thank you, Senator Ehtezaz Ehsan, for taking off time to be the honorable guest on this occasion.
Thank you, Setna Sahab, for sharing with us the memorable journey of the formation of the Jameel Naqsh Foundation. I would like to request Mrs. Marjory Hussain, who is a legend herself in the art circle and a contemporary and a close friend of Jameel Naqsh, to say a few words.
Good evening. It's such a pleasure to be here this evening, and we've waited so long for this wonderful museum, and it's nice to see friends, the artists. I can see Naeed Raza here, so many artists. It's wonderful to be here. Congratulations. Shazam shows the talent of the family by his architecture and what he's done here. This is truly beautiful. And really, what it reminds me of the days when the friends of Jameel Naqsh got together and formed a museum in what area was that? That was? Yes, Sharif. And I'd like to mention them because all that they did in those days has led to this place today. It's beautiful. At that time, there were friends of museum, friends of Jameel Museum, and also Shami was running a very busy gallery. It was a very happy time we look back on with Jameel's, not only his own work, but the people he was teaching. It was so beautiful. And I would like to mention the names of all the people who have been involved, if I may. Aisha Usmani, Dinar and Farid and Setna, Ifat and Khurshid Yazdani, Meher and Hussein Sharif, Muhammad Ali, Hassan Ali, Moni and Jangir Tareen, Najmi Surah, Ronak Lekhani, Salma and M.M. Usmani, Tayyiba and Muslim Habib. And these were the people who years ago saw the possibilities of what we could do and what has been done now. And we have also to look forward to Najmi Surah's exhibition, which is very exciting. And I'm so happy to be here this evening. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Majri, for sharing with us. I would like to extend my gratitude and thanks to all the role players that have helped it make possible today. We couldn't have arrived at this point without their help and support. Please bear me while I take some time to acknowledge them. First and foremost, Ms. Najmi Sura, for her guidance, encouragement, love and support for all of us. To Ms. Shami Ahmed, for her eternal love and ever willingness to help me out. To Ms. Janila Ahmed, for her passion, energy and timely advices. To Susila and Mona Naksh, for their help and support. To Simran and Muqeed, for putting up with me. And most of all, to my husband Suzan, for his support and all the hard work for months to make this event possible and memorable for all of us. There are many more people who have helped us in many different ways to overcome different obstacles. This has not been possible only because of you. Friends of Jameel Naksh and I would like to thank all the people who are present and also to the people who are not here in person but are with us in their spirits. It all would not have been possible without you. Let me invite you all to please enjoy the magnificent pieces of art by the master and wish you all a very pleasant evening. Thank you.
कबूतर और एक खातून सब्जेक्ट हो और एंड उनकी पोर्ट्रेट्स बेसिकली पोर्ट्रेट्स बड़ा अच्छा है बड़ी अच्छी स्पेसेस है और स्पेसेस इतनी कुशादा भी है कि व्यूअर पीछे हट के पर्सपेक्टिव को देख सकता है और तस्वीर को इन पर्सपेक्टिव देख सकता है और अरेंजमेंट इसका म्यूजियम का काफ़ी अच्छा है। उसका एंट्रेंस में मुझे बड़ा अच्छा लगा कि एंट्रेंस में एकदम कुशादा स्पेस है जो यहाँ नहीं है और आप एंट्रेंस में ही बहुत सारी नुमाइश को और नुमाइश करदा तस्वीर को देख सकते हैं और उसका ये बड़ा एडवांटेज है डाइवर्सिटी दिखाए। म्यूजियम तो तरक्की तब करता है अगर डाइवर्सिटी डिस्प्ले कर सके और डाइवर्सिटी में यानी मुख्तलिफुल अनवा जानरे हो मीडियम्स ऑफ आर्ट हो करते रहे और मकामी सारे पाकिस्तानी ने, तो उससे ये खूब तरक्की कर सकता।
देखिए, मेरे इल्म में जितना उनका काम है जो मैंने देखा है, और मेरे पास उनका भी कलेक्शन है, इज़ बीन वेरी काइंड टू मी कि उन्होंने मुझे बना के दिए हैं, उसमें सबसे जो ज़्यादा है वो मुझे कबूतर वाले जो उनकी पेंटिंग्स हैं, क्योंकि उससे एक मैसेज जा रहा है जो कि एस्थेटिक सेंस में तो बड़ा पावरफुल मैसेज है, लेकिन सब्लाइम तरीके से भी उसका एक मैसेज है कि इस ज़माने में जहां इतनी हलचल है, जहां इतनी तफरकेबाजी है, जहां इतना डिवाइसिवनेस है, हम जो हैं वो पीस की तरफ, अमन की तरफ कैसे जाएं, और अमन का जो सिंबल होता है, जो अलमबरदार होता है, वो कबूतर होता है। तो मेरे अपने जहन में ये बहुत ज़बरदस्त उनका कंट्रीब्यूशन है, और जो मैसेज देना चाहते हैं इसको हमें डिसेमिनेट करना चाहिए। उनका जो फ़न है वो हर पेंटिंग उनकी जो है वो एक यूनिक पेंटिंग है, और यूनिक पेंटिंग्स में आप किसी को चूज़ नहीं कर सकते। तो मेरे पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से तो उनकी हर पेंटिंग जो है वो एक अनमोल पेंटिंग है, तो मेरे लिए उसको सेलेक्ट करना जो है वो बहुत मुश्किल काम है। बहुत अच्छा इनकी जो क्यूरेटर हैं उन्होंने बड़ा अच्छा काम किया है, और बहुत ही सिलेक्टिव तरीके से जो चीज़ें मेरा ख़्याल है कि बहुत ही प्रोमिनेंट हैं, बहुत नुमायाँ हैं, बहुत कैप्टिवेटिंग हैं, उनको यहाँ पर डिस्प्ले किया है। मुझे उम्मीद है कि शायद वो इसको रोटेट करते रहेंगे ताकि जमील नश का और भी जो काम है, उनका बड़ा ज़बरदस्त कंट्रीब्यूशन है, वो यहाँ पर डिस्प्ले होता रहे। बहुत अच्छी बात है, और मैं फाउंडर्स को मुबारकबाद देता हूँ कि हमारी जो सॉफ्ट इमेज है पाकिस्तान की, वो आर्ट, कल्चर, पेंटिंग्स, लिटरेचर, पोइट्री, इनसे बेहतर होगी फिल्म। तो जब मैं स्टेट बैंक में था, मैंने स्टेट बैंक का म्यूज़ियम और आर्ट गैलरी की, जिसमें सातकैन साहब की सारी पेंटिंग्स मैंने जमा करके वहाँ पर, जो म्यूरल्स थे वो मैंने वहाँ पर रखे। अब स्कूलों के बच्चे जो हैं वो हर इतवार को वहाँ पर आते हैं, बाहर के जो विज़िटर्स हैं जो कराची को विज़िट करते हैं, उनके लिए स्टेट बैंक का म्यूज़ियम जो है और गैलरी एक मस्ट स्टॉप हो गया है। तो मुझे उम्मीद है कि जमील नश का म्यूज़ियम भी, बोथ फॉर आर चिल्ड्रन एज वेल एज फॉर द फॉरेनर्स, एक किस्म का विजिटिंग सलोन होगा जिसमें लोग आएंगे और अपने आप को इंजॉय करेंगे।
What seems to me, he's, it would seem that his subjects are restricted to few, but it is amazing that this person who has painted thousands of birds, and yet you will never find two paintings similar in any way. Each work of art is entirely different. It's amazing. I mean, if any one artist was to concentrate on one subject, you would immediately say after a while that it is boring to see any more of his work, because, but in Jamil Saab's, every painting is unique. I haven't been able to see the whole thing, yes, but I have seen over a period of time when the initial museum was started, and I think he's a, I don't, I'm not an art critic, so I really can't give you an answer, but all I can say is that this man is, his painting skills, his techniques, his ability to draw, he is a complete artist. He hasn't gone into the modern trends, and yet his work is modern. He has done abstract paintings also, he has told the world that he can paint anything he wants to. I mean, even still lifes. Specialized in the human body. I think he's one of the greatest painters of nude in the world. I mean, you compare him with all the famous European artists, and yet he's so different from them. His nudes are different from them. I think he's just amazing artist. I think it can, yes. And I think, you know, just because there is a certain trend which is now present, abstraction, and it doesn't mean that Mr. Naksh would be considered dated. No. When the cycle of change comes around, he will again be considered, we consider him a great master. And I'm sure he will also be considered a great master from among all the artists of the world.
Jamil Naksh ke kaam mein jo hai, ek to ye hai ki jo subject hai, woman and pigeon. Aur jo pigeon hai, इत्तेफाक से मेरा जो है जमील के वहाँ जो ना काफ़ी आना जाना था, और उसके जो ना पिजन जो ना जो उसने पाले थे वो भी देखे थे, तो जिससे वो इंस्पायर होता था. और जो है वो आई मीन जो कैनवस पे वो रियल जो है ले के आए, मैं समझता हूँ जो पिजन वहाँ पे थे उनसे बढ़ के वो लेकर आए. और जो है मतलब जो है वो पिजन वगैरह उस ज़माने से ही जो ना मैं उसके देखता आया हूँ, और जो ना बहुत ही उसको देख के जो है इंस्पायर होता हूँ.
आपने एक पूरा म्यूजियम अभी घुमाया, तो आपका ओवरऑल म्यूजियम का एक्सपीरियंस कैसा रहा?
मैं जब पहली दफ़ा सुना सजान से कि देखो अबू का म्यूजियम खुलने वाला है तो आपको आना है, तो मैं इतना खुश हुआ कि मेरे को पता नहीं था कि दे आर वर्किंग ऑन इट. तो मतलब मेरे को ये जो है ना, मैं समझता हूँ ये बहुत अच्छा काम हुआ है, और इतने बड़े आर्टिस्ट इस ऑनर देना समझा ना बहुत ज़रूरी है समझा. मैं समझता हूँ खाली गुलजी का जो है ना म्यूजियम वगैरह बना है, इससे पहले और किसी आर्टिस्ट का बना नहीं है, लेकिन जमील जो है जमील है. और मतलब मैंने जो है जमील के बारे में पढ़ा भी बहुत है, तो ये वो जो ग्रुप था जो शाकिर अली जो मकसूद मनवर्स एंड ऑल दैट यू नो, तो ये वो ग्रुप था कि इसमें जो है ना ये उभर के सब आए हैं, और जमील माशाल्लाह से सबसे ज़्यादा उभरे हैं. एक तो चीज़ मैं जो है ना पहले मैंने मिसअंडरस्टूड था कि मैं समझा इसमें खाली जमील नक्श का ही काम लगेगा, बट आई बिलीव कि यहाँ पे जो है और आर्टिस्ट के भी काम आएंगे, तो बट मेजॉरिटी तो जमील का ही आएगा. तो और जो है मेरे ख्याल है कि हमसे जो है ना लोग पूछते हैं कि आफ्ताब कौन सा आर्टिस्ट लेना चाहिए, तो हम बोलते हैं कि अगर सही मानों में लेना है तो आप जमील नक्श लो. तो जमील नक्श की दयान के लिए हम जो है ना इधर उधर नहीं जा सकते, क्योंकि सब जगह फेक होते हैं, तो ये वो जगह है कि जहाँ जो है ना गारंटी हमको कोई फिक्र ही नहीं हो. तो मास्टर्स के फेक बहुत बनते हैं, और जमील के तो इंतहाई ज़्यादा बनते हैं, बिकॉज के वो इतना सॉट आफ्टर आर्टिस्ट है.
My name is Dr. Maya Azani. I work for Welfare Society for Patient Care. I'm here at the Jamil Naksh inauguration. We are very grateful to Jamil Naksh because he has been a big influence in not only helping our charity but also being very supportive. He's donated pieces to help our patients in fundraising, and we're very grateful. I think Jamil Naksh himself is a master. Of course, I know very little bit about art, but what he represents is, and his paintings represent female emancipation, and it represents a patriarchy and all the positive things we're looking for in today's world about female empowerment. So that's great. It's a good thing. It's a great space. It's very big. There's lots of light. It's also, I love that all the paintings are spaced in a sense that you get a good essence of and feel of the place. And also, it's welcome to everyone, which is great. It's a very good thing. So in Pakistan today, of course, we have a lot of creative expression that needs to be expressed. We have a lot of young, upcoming artists that need to be represented. And I think this will be a great place, not only for the old, but also to make way for the new, young people to display their work and to express their creativeness.
I've known Jameel Naqsh Saab for a very long time. And he has always embodied or has always represented people who have been downtrodden, who are trying to make an impression in the world. And throughout these years, I've seen him evolve, his paintings becoming more and more refined. And I think this whole museum is something like is a piece of art, but it's still a bit confined to what this man really represents, because it is across the borders, it's across all lines, and his mental thinking is so beyond that I think we probably need 10 museums like this to really showcase him. Because I've known Jameel Saab for so many years that I can say this, that this man deserves more. See, Jameel Saab is a very, very introverted person. He does not go to people's houses. But he was so kind. This was, I'm talking about 20 years ago. And we had just moved into our new house. And I invited him. But I was sure he would not come for that dinner that we had just invited him and Najmi. And I was so touched that he came. And he gave me such a beautiful calligraphy of Bismillah Rahman Rahim. And that actually showcases in our house. As people walk in, they see that calligraphy of Jameel Saab. So that is what the man is, a man of heart.